This is a video from YouTube that is of the halo clouds seen over Moscow on, I believe, October 11th, 2009. As you look at this, kind of look around at the center, you can see the lighter clouds back towards in the distance on the right, and they get darker closer to the person taking the picture on the left. Notice right here along the cloud line, notice how that is kind of expanding and pushing down a little bit as this video is taken, and especially the structure of those clouds around the side. Now this is going into just a thing I pulled off of YouTube of some British soldiers that were in the area in the Pacific where they were testing hydrogen bombs. And this was let off 8,000 feet in the atmosphere. Look at the similar cloud formation. Look how that middle part here is pushing down on the mushroom cloud, and the clouds are spinning around. The exact cloud formation is what really struck my mind when I saw the Moscow halo, is that it looks like the old footage that I'd seen of aerial hydrogen bomb testing, atomic bomb testing, whatever, back in the 40s, 50s, 60s. Yeah, if you look around and you see those clouds up there and how they're spinning and how that middle section of darkness is kind of pushing down, and you see that light reflecting again, to me what it looks like is it's being produced by the immense heat that's being created right there. It's pushing the air out. It's deforming the structure of the air pressure in a really quick way. So here's the Moscow video again. Look how those clouds bear similarity to the mushroom cloud that's in the footage that we just saw, right there. How those clouds, when they come around and they're making that circular shape, they just look similar, I think. Here's the Moscow video again. Now, it's also very interesting to me that in a city of millions of people, so little footage has been put out about this. This was somebody's cell phone camera that took it, and they send it off, as I understand it. And it was downloaded by people like me and put up on YouTube from people all around the world. Couldn't really stop that one. I'd be interested to see the other footage that was confiscated. What you've got up there is probably a large craft that took off at a really high rate of speed, and the heat that was generated by that created that heat signature cloud that you see. It's interesting. I see some of the UFO, or excuse me, the YouTube videos of the Moscow halo listed as mothership or UFO, and it's silly. This is post mothership or post UFO in the sky. This is the heat signature in the clouds that's left when one of those crafts takes off at a really high rate of speed. As far as cloaking devices and things like that, not to get too Star Trekky, but just read up on the Philadelphia experiment. It's the technology is out there. Geez, it's in Popular Science and Discover magazine now. So that's my assumption, is that it was a craft over Moscow. Either that, or they were trying to get rid of maybe a small nuclear weapon and tossed it up into the sky to see what would happen. Maybe somebody had too much vodka that day. Of course, I'm kidding. I'm kidding. It's a joke. I'm Russian, so I'm allowed to kid. All right, well, that's my weird YouTube analogy of the halo over Moscow in October of 2009, and why I think that it was caused from a large circular craft taking off at a very high rate of speed and creating a heat signature by displacing the air so much with the temperature differential. Thanks, have a good day.
Left baffled by an unexplained circular light seen hovering high over Moscow on Wednesday evening, scientists have rejected claims of UFO activity, saying the white cloud was no more than an optical illusion. In the western part of Moscow, people described seeing a wide circular formation in the sky. Footage capturing the spectacle will help weather scientists and specialists find an explanation for the event. They will examine weather conditions that could lead to such an effect, while chemical pollution has been ruled out as a potential cause.